Hello friends, welcome to this video on triangles. In the previous session, we discussed about the side-side-side criterion or the SSS congruence rule. Today, we will solve some questions based on it. Let's start with a question. In triangle DEF, point C is the midpoint of side DE and side EF is equal to side FD. Then, are triangle CEF and triangle CDF congruent? Friends, can you tell what type of triangle this is by looking at the figure? You may pause the video to think about the answer. Yes, friends, two sides of this triangle are equal. Therefore, this is an isosceles triangle. Observe the diagram carefully. In triangle DEF, point C is the midpoint of side DE. That's why side DC and side EC are equal. Now observe triangle CEF and triangle CDF. We are given that side EF is equal to side DF and CF is the common side. By looking at equations 1, 2 and 3, we can say that according to the side-side-side criterion or the SSS congruence rule, these two triangles are congruent because all three sides of these two triangles are equal. Now let's move to the next question. In the given figure, PQRS and PMRN are parallelograms. Point M and point N are midpoints of sides PQ and SR respectively. Show that triangle PSN is congruent to triangle RQM. Friends, it's given that PQRS is a parallelogram. Therefore, its opposite sides will be equal, which means side PQ and SR are equal and sides PS and QR are also equal. Point M is the midpoint of PQ. That's why we can write PQ like this. Point N is the midpoint of side SR. That's why we can write SR like this. As we saw, side PQ is equal to side SR. So these two will also be equal to each other. Now we got QM as equal to SN. And since PMRN is a parallelogram, its opposite sides will be equal. This means side PM is equal to side NR and side PN is equal to side MR. Friends, look carefully. Now we can say that in triangle PSN and triangle RQM, all three sides are equal. Side PS is equal to side RQ, side SN is equal to side QM, and side PN is equal to side RM. Therefore, these two triangles are congruent according to the SSS congruence rule. Friends, if we draw diagonal MN in PMRN by joining point M and point N, then will the formed triangles PMN and NRM be congruent? Pause the video and check your answer and try to reach the conclusion on your own. That's it for today's session. Today we solved some questions based on the side-side-side criterion or the SSS congruence rule. See you in the next video. Thank you.